Something strange is occurring underneath Japan, likely indicating the movement of something at depth. What I am referring to is an unusual series of thousands of deep earthquakes striking one after the other in far western Honshu, approximately 18 kilometers east-northeast of the city of Hagi. The surface rocks above the epicenter of these abundant quakes initially may not look all too notable, appearing fairly similar to that of the surrounding mountain ranges. However, while unusual in Japan, their highly eroded appearance hides a simple fact. Everything outlined on screen is part of a young and still active volcanic field. This marks the 440 square kilometer boundary of the Abu volcanic field, which produced two explosive Holocene volcanic eruptions. These youngest eruptions occurred in 9450 BCE, forming a 1 square kilometer island lava plateau, and in 6850 BCE, creating a cinder cone on top of it, with these forming a landmass northwest of the Hagi fishing port. In other words, in my interpretation, these ongoing earthquakes are probably magmatic in origin. These suspicious earthquakes began on February 1st earlier this year, starting at a depth of 40 kilometers. These were unprecedentedly deep, as generally speaking, earthquakes in the vicinity occur in association with known or presumed fault lines at less than 20 kilometers depth. And yet, they seemingly began in the lowermost layer of the crust above the Moho layer, as the regional crust is estimated to only be between 41 and 44 kilometers thick. And these were no ordinary earthquakes, consisting of a subtype known as low-frequency earthquakes. Per a direct quote from the U.S. Geological Survey, low-frequency LF earthquakes are caused by cracks resonating as magma and gases move towards the surface. They are often seen prior to volcanic eruptions, but their occurrence is also part of the normal background seismicity at some volcanoes, and their occurrence does not necessarily indicate that an eruption is imminent. Now, I do want to note that low-frequency earthquakes can also be caused by other fluids such as water moving, but water being the culprit can essentially be ruled out due to the absurdly deep depth these quakes are occurring at. The first 36 days saw only 24 earthquakes strike, but then, on March 9th, activity notably escalated. Earthquakes became substantially more common, and they were now striking at around 31 kilometers depth. A continuous upward pattern, probably due to a body of rising viscous magma, seemingly saw earthquakes generally get 2 kilometers or 1.2 miles shallower every week. This pattern continued until March 23rd, when the number of earthquakes dropped and then jumped 5 kilometers deeper again. I interpret that the intrusion branched off underground and began a secondary pathway upwards. Earthquakes became more abundant once again, getting shallower and shallower until the end of the first week of April. Thereafter, there was no apparent pattern in the depth of earthquakes striking at between 24 and 31 kilometers depth. Activity eventually declined throughout the remainder of the month, only to pick up once again in May. In total, 2,050 earthquakes have been observed in this swarm, which, due to their uniform small magnitude, have not caused any damage or even been felt by anyone to the best of my knowledge. So, does this unusual swarm, if it is being caused by a batch of rising magma, indicate that a new or existing vent in the Abu volcanic field will soon erupt? To this they say probably not, due to the absurdly slow rise and then apparent stalling of the magma. I generally say that about 9 out of 10 magmatic intrusions does not result in a volcanic eruption, and the behavior of this potential intrusion leads me to believe it is most likely not going to eventually reach the surface. Something similar happened underneath the northwest section of California's Lake Tahoe in 2003, with magma rising from 42 to 23 kilometers depth. And of course, that also did not result in any eruption. As a final note, I would like to thank my patron Matthew Whitford for upgrading their Patreon membership tier to this channel.